Hi, it's Miss Christine, and I'm here for a super quick SAT ACT tip today. And the big thing I wanted to talk about is even after a year of the new SAT out, I've seen recently, I mean, just in the last week or so, people still using the old SAT study guides. There's some still being used in schools, which is really unusual. But the real big problem with that is the archaic vocabulary that we if you've been following SAT for quite a while, you'll know that was a big problem or a lot of complaints. So what the new SAT, it does have vocabulary, but it's more in line with what you would be using in everyday life in your education. It doesn't have those strange words that haven't been used in publications for decades at all. So when you're studying for the SAT or ACT, make sure that you're going on to their official websites or you're working with people who really know what they're doing and know that they're working on the current ones. The best way to study those vocabulary actually is to be reading the newspapers or magazines, and not your local little newspapers, but but bigger ones like the Wall Street Journal or the New Yorker, and trying to pick out words that they use. Those are or reading high level literature, like the ones that are winning the Nobel Prize and things like that. And that's it. Just quick and easy. I hope it helps, and have a fantastic day.